काउसेस फर्स्ट नेशन दे मुखी ने एनडीपी आगू जगमीत सिंह नाल मिलके रिहायशी स्कूलों दे मुद्दे ते गलबात की है। कनेडा विच फैडरल चोणां दे मद्देनज़र मूल निवासी कम्युनिटीज़ नूं भरमाउण लई तरह तरह के पापड़ वेले जा रहे हैं।
Well, Todd, you know what? It's a bit like a knife fight in a telephone booth. It's hard to come out of it and survive, I think, for anyone for the first week, because it was pretty clear that all of the opposition party leaders were piling on the Liberals and attacking Justin Trudeau for calling an election. Justin Trudeau, I think, effectively got through the week. But the big question is if this continues to dog Justin Trudeau and the Liberals, it'll be bad news for them and a lot of turbulence. On the positive side of the ledger, the Erin O'Toole and the Conservatives managed to launch their platform and say that they had a plan. And he managed to dodge the bullet on the A word, abortion, in terms of declaring his position. But he's still being pursued, or at least asking questions related to the vaccinations. And Jagmeet Singh has actually had a pretty good week in terms of focusing on housing and the environment. So I'm not sure if there's a winner yet. I think we'll have to wait. This is kind of a long movie, well, like a marathon.
Yeah, well, it's one of those standard for all of us that have been following Canadian politics for decades. It's been like the standard Liberal ploy, tactic, trap, to try to trip up whoever happens to be the Conservative leader of the day on abortion. Stephen Harper never fell for the trap and basically knocked it out of the park in terms of telling Canadians that the decision has been made and that's the past, and Stephen Harper wanted to focus on the future. Andrew Scheer stumbled a bit in the last federal election, and it basically started a bit of a pattern where he was on the defensive. Erin O'Toole has basically put this to rest, and I'm sure he wants to talk about his plan in the economy in the future. So I think we've now put this behind us on the campaign trail, and it'll be interesting. And I think what Canadians want is to hear from all of the federal party leaders about the issues that matter for the future, jobs in the economy, healthcare, the environment, all those things, and to stop what I'll say the bickering and the pot shots of the last few days and to focus on the future and the big issues that really touch the lives of Canadians. This is the crux of the matter, and the Nova Scotia election was a good case in point. You know, the Progressive Conservatives in Nova Scotia won not because they were huggable and nice and all that kind of stuff. They won because they focused on one issue, healthcare, investing in healthcare and the future of healthcare, and they were rewarded by the electorate in Nova Scotia, as opposed to the Liberals in Nova Scotia, who tried to do a little bit of a victory lap. So it's about the future, not what have you done for me lately, but what will you do in the future, and what is your vision for the future? Well, the New Democrats actually, Jagmeet Singh, in his opening response on the first day of the campaign, talked about the environmental crisis and the housing crisis at the same time. So he's been focused on that, as has Annamie Paul. What we've seen, at least in the last number of weeks, is that the environment is starting to creep up as a top national issue of concern. We also know from the research that we've done is that when we ask Canadians which issues would influence their vote in a possible federal election, the environment came second after jobs and the economy. So it's definitely on the radar, and it's definitely top of mind in terms of what Canadians want to hear about.